and welcome to what we think is the most commodious estate car on the market today, the E-Class Mercedes-Benz. Now, most estate cars have bottoms like Kate Moss, but this is a real Brunhilde. It is colossal in here, and it must be said, rather well thought out. There are points for lashing your dog to the floor, and the seats can be erected easily to muffle its howls of protest. There's a cargo net to stop it flying forward should you run into something, and a power point in case it wants to play computer games. It can even store its tiara in a cubbyhole under the floor. The guys who do interior design at Mercedes-Benz have so much common sense. If you asked them to lay a table, it would look like this, everything exactly where it's supposed to be. Now, there are some manufacturers, you give them exactly the same ingredients and you get it completely wrong. You just have to look at the cockpit of this car to see what I'm on about. I can close my eyes and everything falls immediately to hand. There's the hazard warning lights. There is the fan. There's the stereo on button, gear lever, electric window switches, electric door mirror switches, there's the lights, there's the indicators. It's amazing. And look in here, they've even put little cool air vents to stop your chocolate melting on a hot day. It's quite a car. It's a good looker too. It's kind of like the Queen, statesmanlike and regal, without being ostentatious. And this one is particularly unostentatious because it's a diesel. Now, ordinarily, when I'm asked to test a diesel, I suddenly think of a million things that need doing instead. The thing is, that Mercedes is, I'm told, the fastest production diesel that money can buy. Fastest. Superlative of fast. Has an appeal, don't you think? Under the bonnet, there's a huge six-cylinder, 3-litre motor with a dirty great turbo for extra get-up-and-go. It gets from 0 to 60 in 8 seconds and can reach, ready for this, 137 miles an hour. It rides well, it handles well, there's none of that, oh my God, we're going to crash understeer that you normally get in a diesel. And it shifts, and I mean, really shifts. Now you're probably thinking, look, if you want performance, why not buy a petrol-powered Merc? Well, I'll tell you. Surprisingly, this is faster. Amazingly, it's cheaper. And inevitably, it's more economical. Now obviously, people who are going to spend £34,000 on a car aren't worried about the odd mile to the gallon, but think about it this way. No one likes filling up with fuel. It's time-consuming and dull, and you always end up buying a Mars bar as well, which makes you fat. But in this, you can just sail past filling stations because it averages 30 miles to the gallon and has a 14-gallon tank. That means you can do 420 miles between trips to the pumps. Sorry, mate. Not today. Or tomorrow, actually. This whole car makes sense. You get a new type of braking system that cuts the emergency stopping distance down by 45%. You get a 5-speed automatic gearbox, you get traction control, and these days you even get a stereo as standard. Obviously, it isn't as refined as its petrol-powered brothers, especially as they now come with super-smooth V6 engines. But on a practical, common-sense level, this is just superb. This is the first diesel I've ever liked, and it's a good estate car. But before I give it a clean bill of health, there's something I need to check out. The BMW 5 Series saloon is perfect, but this is the new turbo diesel estate, and it's not. BMW's diesel is so thirsty you're better off with a smoother, more powerful petrol engine. And for the same money as the Mercedes, you could have a 5-8 ISE with satellite navigation and a TV set. Sounds tempting. But then the BMW has a pathetically small boot. So what's it going to be? A petrol BMW with a thimble nailed to its rear end, or the diesel-powered Brunhilde? Well, this is the better, more practical estate car. Oh, no! You know what I've done, don't you? I've just made a reasoned argument for buying a diesel in preference to a petrol. Howling gaff! What have I done? I'm not old enough for diesels. What have I done?